Ah, the taste is very special because the meat is rice in the nature and a taste very strong. So you mix them because too much, it's like too much strong flavor. So, and the type of cut of the meat, well, it's not only tight cut. You can go to the butcher in our area and ask for two-tier meat cut, which away in Quebec you can't ask this, but in our area you can ask this and you have the perfect size of cutting. Then, and this is like very in the Christmas, New Year time or when you have a party, it's the kind of meal we cook. So we also have the poutine that have been invented in the French part also, and now is known as the national specialty of all Canada. So this is the classic one, French fries, gravy, and grainy cheese. But you can find like many type, like some will go very fancy and add some duck in the poutine and things like this. In my area again, we do chocolate of fresh blueberries, but it's wild blueberries from our area because there have been a big fire that almost just burned down all the area where we lived. And after this, those blueberries grows very easily, so we have them everywhere. Almost like the plant that you want to kill but you can't always grow. So we have this but everywhere. So we're happy because it's a very good fruit. And they have a very special taste in comparison to the one you can buy at store. It's really different. They are smaller and the flavor is very more explosive, very more sweet. It's no OGM. And we take them to make fresh chocolate. And we keep them in fridge because the blueberry isn't dry, it's very fresh. So when you bite it, it explodes, it's good. And we count in my era, like people from Montreal or Quebec, they call us the blueberries because we have them everywhere. So it's kind of a nickname we also have. Oh, and another food specialty, we have the soup au gourgane, feta bean soup. I'm not sure of the translation, but that's what I found. So it's the kind of big bean that is big like my inch, like this. This grows a lot in our area, and we have a soup for this. It's also like we serve before the main deal in party or in Noel, Christmas, and New Year. So we welcome our guests and have this soup for them before the main tourtière. We also have the pork leg stew. We have this meal in many countries, but we do it a little bit differently. So this is how it looks like in my area. And I also have another picture down here. It's a meat pie, and it's very special. If you ever go in my country, in Montreal, they will tell you that this is a tourtière, but it's the biggest slice of history. It's just a meat pie. And they sell this, but they have no idea what they do because a meat pie is like 45-minute cooking, and a tourtière actually takes 9 or 10 hours of cooking, slow cooking, because the meat is like boiled into a gravy and bouillon, and also with a lot of spice, and that's why we cook it very slowly to everything like massage. The flavor just mix and blend, and it takes a long time for it. And I also have other pictures on this page about when I told you earlier, interesting place to go, I forgot to mention the Lake Louise, which is no Photoshop, it's literally blue like this. And it's a very gorgeous place to go. If you cross the Canada, you have to stop there. My friend have been there and I saw their pictures, it's exactly like this. So, I'll just make it. You can see over. And the activity is really good. In the Sagnac Saint-Jean, where we do a lot of maquette à neige. Like this. This is the traditional racket made by the autochtones. The, I should call them the Indians, the original people. I think I found the snowshoes as translation for this. And we do also cross-country ski a lot, because we are not like people think we have a lot of high mountains, but not that much. So we do ski, but also cross-country ski is popular. And ice skating on lakes, and sometimes rivers, because in winter it's cold enough, so there's a very big amount of ice, and it's safe enough to just go skating on ice, and not inside door, we just go outside and put a skate on there. Yeah. And we have a train washing, dog sleigh, that we do also in my area. With the dog, wolf dog, and husky, and all these, you can. It's an activity we can do very often. There's also the skidoo that is probably the most famous one. Everyone knows the skidoo. It's a bit annoying actually, because they are everywhere. And in summer, it's the four wheel. It's also common. Like even if you live in countryside area, most people have a second residency, even more lost in the forest, in the road, to just relax and do their own thing, fishing. And this is one camp that looks one very pretty one, but there is many range of camp, so you have more basic to very pretty one. We also do a lot of fishing on ice in winter, like you can see on those pictures. So we see the man has just burst a hole in the ice, and he put a line in it and just triggered the line and whoop. And after this, the picture, it says a temporary village on ice. It's a small camp, like you can get in maybe 3 or 4 people sitting. And it's also for the fishing on ice, so because there's nowhere to hide from the wind, so they build small camp just to hide from the wind, because it can be cold, they spend all their day there. And so it's temporary, because when the spring come back, you see all those camp, they are moved from the water, and then you see them on the road. On trailers, and you see like many little camps going out. It's so just funny every spring to see this on the road. And yeah, I just made this simply. Any question about the carrot you would like to ask? Yeah, that would be fun. Questions? Go and see. The food is
nice. We want to try. Next week, we bring the food.
Yeah.